Locate the absolute extrema of the function on the given interval. So number 41, we have f sub x is equal to 2x plus 2 from 0 to 1, meaning the graph goes from 0 up to 1. And 4x squared from 1 to 3, meaning the graph goes from 1 to 3. So this is the graph of the function. So this is 2x plus 2, and this is the graph of the parabola 4x squared. So the graph goes from 0 to 1 and 1 to 3. Now, let's get the derivative of its function. So the first function, let's call it a sub x. So this is 2x plus 2. So the derivative of this is equal to 2. And the second function is g sub x is 4x squared. So the derivative of this is equal to 8x. So 4 multiplied by 2 is 8. Then you subtract 1 in your exponent. So it's turned to be to the 1. Now, as you can see, we will not have the same derivative at x is equal to 1. So the first derivative is 2. The second derivative, if x is equal to 1, will be 8. So 8 multiplied by 1 is 8, so meaning the graph doesn't meet on the graph of the derivative, doesn't meet on one point. Then you will say, okay, the derivative doesn't exist, so there will be no absolute extrema, which is wrong. The derivative doesn't exist at x is equal to 1, but it doesn't mean there's no graph. So this is the graph of the derivative. So at this point, at x is equal to 1, they don't meet. So the derivative at x is equal to 1 does not exist. But still, you will have the maximum and the minimum. If you graph the first function, the graph of the derivative of h prime is 2, and the graph of the derivative of the second function is this one. So when you graph it, let's do it. When you equate it this to 0 to get the extrema, this is not possible. When you equate your derivative 8x, equate it to 0, to get the extrema, then divide by 8, so you have 0 is equal to 8, or 0 is equal to x. So which is the same thing with our endpoint. So our critical number 0 is the same thing with our left endpoint of 0. Now let's substitute our left endpoint or our critical number of 0 to our original function, which is 0, 2x plus 2, because here the 4x squared, the graph 4x squared doesn't exist at x is equal to 0. So we will do a sub 0 is equal to 2 multiplied by 0 plus 2. So this will be equal to 0 plus 2. So therefore it is 2. Now for the right endpoint, which is equal to 3, you substitute from 4x squared 3, which is our endpoint. So we have 4 multiplied by 3 squared. So this is 4 multiplied by 9, which is equal to 36. Okay, so we can say that this is our maximum. This is the absolute maximum and this is the absolute minimum.